Good morning, my Aquarians. It's 4:30 a.m., correct? 4:38 a.m., and we are doing your reading. My air signs. I got up early. I always get up. I usually get up about 2:30 to 3 in the morning. So yeah, we are doing your reading, my lovely Aquarians. Tomorrow, I just want to say, is the energy check-in to see what new is coming in for you. Please join me if you want to see what's new coming in for you. It's 8 a.m. Central Standard Time, starting with our lovely Virgos. They're the birthday boys and girls of the season, working our way through to the Leos. Sundays are also the bonus reads, top three viewed highest signs. So there is that. Do you like the new mug, Aquarius? Look at manifesting my best life. Isn't that great? I hope all of you are manifesting your best life, consciously manifesting. Looks like Virgo too. Somebody said that in the comments. Very, very true. Let's manifest our best lives. I am using Enchanted Tarot for the main deck. I'm using Tarot de Cinque for the clarifying deck. The links to these decks can be found down below in the description box, along with links to other decks I use. Not my decks, just trying to make it easier for you guys to check them out. Some people like to look it over and see the images closer. And as always, Aquarius, thank you so, 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 so much for supporting the channel and watching and viewing and liking and subscribing. I can't thank you guys enough. I really can't. And for all my new viewers, welcome. And if you're feeling the vibe, please feel free to like and subscribe. The Tower, I can't stop. I have to get into this. I have to. What is this? The Tower and the Ace of Pentacles. Something new. And for some of you, when I saw that, I always shuffle the clarifying deck first. And when I shuffled it, I'm like, okay, what's this new? And then when I did the Tower, the first thing I thought, some of you, if you are waiting to hear back from a job, I feel like it's gonna go in your favor, it's weird to think that because I'm not seeing justice here, but or like a legal matter, or maybe you're waiting on some type of decision that involves money. Oh, I have to sneeze, I apologize. Excuse me, I do not have COVID. Every time I sneeze, I have to say that I do not have COVID. Okay. Yes, so if you're waiting to hear on something, especially regarding money, I think it feels really positive. Put it that way. What's the Ace of Pentacles? The King of Pentacles. Queen of Cups reverse and the Knight of Wands is something you want. That feels like something you want. The Queen of Cups reverse, but preparing for it. But I think something's going your way. I just want to say that. King of Pentacles feels like a lot of money. Or the energy to go get it. And of course, this could be feels like a new job, to be honest, is just what that feels like. That's really leveling your finances up. We have the Tower, Eight of Coins, and the Star reverse. So maybe you lost a job and applying for something. Five of Swords reverse. Yeah, I know. Let's see what this is about. Very intriguing, Aquarius, very intriguing. All right, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus, Aquarius. If you are Aquarius, know an Aquarius, feel like being an Aquarius, well, Aquarians, I'm so glad you're here. You can be an Aquarius and this resonates. You can be dealing with an Aquarius and you can resonate as the main story. I know it's not pretty shuffling this deck. It is so massive for my hands. And yes, I know, Aquarius, what you're going to say. That's what she said. And that is what she is saying. This deck is way too big for... I like that. That's why the Tarot Mystical Moments, I think, is like a perfect size for me. But this deck, I felt really drawn to it this week, and I'm glad I am using it. But yeah, it's not a pretty sight shuffling. Sometimes it is, and sometimes it isn't. And for some reason, it's weird, because maybe that's the energy you're in. It's like, it's messy, but somehow it comes together in the end. I feel like something's coming together in the end for you here. It's taken a lot of twists and turns. A lot of like, is this happening? And I feel like something's ready to happen. All right, just wanted to say that. Aquarians, Sun, Moon, Rising, Venus. What are the collective messages? Ooh, eyes itching. What are the collective messages for the Aquarians? What are the collective messages for the Aquarians? Maybe we'll get a sunrise, Aquarius. Isn't that beautiful? We've had enough sunsets in our life. Sunsets are beautiful, but then there's the darkness, right? We're ready for a sunrise in our life, a new beginning. That's that Three of Wands, ready for an adventure. What is this card? The Page of Cups, hope, new beginnings, happiness. It's messages, love, dreamer, heart on sleeve, sensitivity, innocence, and idealism. Page of Cups to me represents hope. And it's so interesting because if you've watched my channel long enough, I say it quite a bit, that I actually always get an Ace of Cups, Page of Cups with Aquarian energy. It's weird because you're the Ace of Swords, you wouldn't be, not the Ace of Cups, but I do get a very feminine energy with Aquarians. I do, in a very good way. What is influencing the Page of Cups? What's influencing the Page of Cups? Look at the Ace of Pentacles, Page of Cups. Love messages. Are you in love, Aquarius? Are you needing to be in love? Are you missing being in love? What's influencing the Page of Cups? There it is. The Knight of Swords reverse, Gemini and energy. Nine of Coins reverse and the Ten of Cups. Eight of Pentacles. Knight of Swords reverse is clarity. It could be clarity on what needs to be cut out. It could be focus, because the Knight of Swords upright could be chaotic. When it's reversed to me, it's about getting more clear on something. Okay, let's see what comes out. Very intriguing so far. What's the reason for the reading? Actually, let's read what Knight of Swords upright. It says it's fast moving, impatience, rash, fearless, brave, daring, direct, going against flow. Maybe it's when you know what that kind of feels like? It's when some of you have given up the idea of something new coming in, that's when it comes in. Because if it's upright saying it's fast moving, maybe you feel like it's just not coming in. And then something happens, something moves, something shifts. The Tower. Remember we started with that at the bottom? There it is again. Something sudden comes in. Just when you give up all hope, here it is. All right, what's the reason for the reading for the Aquarians? What's the reason for the reading for the Aquarians? What's the reason for the reading? There, King of Cups. Did you see how it came out? I just did Gemini's reading and it was on their mind. I feel like, yeah, the King of Cups, reason for the reading. New love, wisdom, calm, diplomatic, caring, tolerant, kind, gentle, emotional control. Being in control of one's emotions, but I'm telling you, this feels like what starts out with messages probably grows into something. I just feel like it grows into something. Something's coming out of the blue for you. Literally, look at the blue here. What is in the past for the Geminians, for the Aquarians, sorry. What's in the past for the Aquarians? What's in the past for the Aquarians? What is in the past for the Aquarians? There it is. The Queen of Cups reverse. Yeah. I feel like being disappointed one too many times. The Knight of Swords reverse. Now that Knight of Swords reverse makes a lot more sense because look at the card next to it. It's about cutting out who has made you sad or who has made you... So the Queen of Cups reverse, you know, all tarot is a spectrum, right? Over here, it could be somebody emotionally unavailable made you really... It could be very needy, could be very depressed energy. Because your needs are not getting met by somebody or an expectation that they were going to get met. And over here, it could just be taking your cup back and protecting your heart space, not putting yourself out there. Either way, the Knight of Swords reverses. What I think is getting clear on this, whoever did this to you, I feel like it's reprioritizing your life, not accepting less than what you deserve energy. Some of you, it was done to you, you healed, you're in between, and you've given up hope that something new and strong and solid are coming in. You've watched tarot reading after tarot reading, it's coming in, and then it's like, I feel like somebody lost hope. And then out of the blue, here it is. Look at that, queen, and turns you in to the Queen of Wands. That's passion, even though she's a bit scary. Yeah, that's amazing, okay. What is on Aquarian's mind? But and it's weird because we got the true pair going on here, but I feel like this King of Cups is new. I'll be honest. I feel like you just haven't met each other yet. Look at this, true pair. I just feel like you were with the wrong person or with the wrong people, Aquarius. And they're it's like you were up here, they're down here. You're reverse saying it's not coming in. This person's like, where is Aquarius? It's like, but you meet. I feel like it's finally happening with this Ace of Pentacles. All right, what's on Aquarian's mind? What is on Aquarian's mind? What is on Aquarian's mind? What is on Aquarian's mind? I actually want to get, for some of you that's in a marriage watching, in the Judgment. Ooh, that's powerful. I've never seen that card in this deck yet, because this deck is really new to me, and the Judgment is waking up. It's new beginnings. It's realizing either what needs to change in your life and going about it, what needs to be let go of in your life, going about it, or what needs to come into your life and going about it. The Judgment is like a new soul contract, is what I feel. Something's completed, something's ready to begin. Judgment, rebirth, awakening, resurrection, inner calling, and transformation. Isn't that a beautiful card? That is really, really pretty. Really, really pretty. And so I want to say, some of you in marriages, it's not about leaving a marriage. It's about reconnecting in a marriage, okay? Because not every tarot reading is, you got to divorce the bastard. No, the Page of Cups is being reconnected. It's finding one's love again. And the Knight of Swords reverses, maybe two people work so much, and then you have responsibilities and you have kids. And I actually feel like maybe you're going to get away, because the Queen of Cups reverse is almost feeling loss of that connection, of that heart space, because the Knight of Swords, Tarot of the Mystical Moments. No, it's not that. If you look at a traditional Knight of Swords card, it's the only knight where the horse is exhausted. The horse has his eyes are really big. He's really tired because the rider's riding him, and not in a good way. You know what I mean? It's too many things you have to do, too much responsibility, too many errands. You got the kids, and you got the school, and you got the work, and then you forget about love. And for some, I want to say for some Aquarians, this is about being reconnected to your partner. I think that's what's going to come about. Judgment, Page of Cups, and King of Cups. Some of you Aquarians, this is definitely new love coming in. Either way, it's wakening up to this queen. This queen put her cup away for whatever reason. And you're finding that again. You're finding that passion again. All right. What is in the near future for the Aquarians? What is in the near future? I want to say, honestly, married, single, whatever this is, it's about finding passion and love again in your life. After a series of disappointments or money issues or problems need to be solved, I feel like you've lost joy and happiness for some time. And this is about getting connected to that aspect of your life. What is the near future for the Aquarians? There it is. We have the Knight of Cups reversed. The two knights are reversed. The king is upright. Again, I think this is, and I actually, with the perspective here in the Four of Cups, maybe with this at the bottom, it's getting that perspective that you just need more love and passion in your life. It's like you could be making good money, but the love aspect of your life might be really not there. Or you could be in a marriage and you lost the romance part aspect of it. Either way, it's getting a new perspective that you need more of this in your life. The Knight of Cups is a dreamy, romantic energy. It's romance, imaginative, sensitive, lover, knight, proposal, offers, and seduction. And I feel like this has not maybe been in your life for some time. You might not be wanting to leave a marriage or a relationship, but you do want that back in. And some of you could be looking for that outside of your connection. But it's really within yourself that it needs to be waking up. Four Cups reverse is a card of apathy, of boredom, of I want more, I need more, and you deserve more, you do need more. And some of you don't need to completely change your Four of Wands and change your relationship out. You just need to refine that spark again. And I feel like I'm getting going away or on a weekend or a trip or something. So the Four of Cups is apathetic, disillusioned, antisocial, unmotivated, stagnated, lacking emotional satisfaction, fatigue, and daydreaming. Feeling like what you want is out there somewhere when really it's within. That's just what I'm really getting here. All right. But anyway, going back to the main part of the reading, I feel like definitely King of Pentacles, Ace of Pentacles. Some of you money-wise, if you're waiting on hearing about something, I think something's going in your favor regards to money. This could be a good time also, with especially the energy of that Virgo new moon. It was really a big clearing and opening our eyes to what we need in our life. And I feel like for the Aquarians, you need more love, passion, happiness in that area. All right. What is this? Page of Cups influenced by the Knight of Swords reverse. Page of Cups influenced by the Knight of Swords reverse. Page of Cups influenced by the Knight of Swords reverse for the Aquarians. What is this? Page of Cups influenced by the Knight of Swords reverse. Page of Cups influenced by the Knight of Swords reverse. It's right there. Yep, Seven of Wands. Seven of Wands is getting attention. I feel like somebody's giving you attention. I think somebody's giving Aquarius attention. I love that. And it's feeling really good. Seven of Wands. Why the Seven of Wands, Leo energy? It feels like something's being re-sparked within you. It might be, and I get with that Page of Cups, the messaging. I feel like maybe you wake up and you can't wait to read somebody's messages. I got that. Okay, what is the Seven of Wands? Why the Seven of Wands? For Aquarians, why the Seven of Wands? And the Four of Pentacles reverse. This is interesting because the Fours talk about stability. The Hangman, did they do it on this card? No, they did not. If any great, I want to say great. That sounds so rude. But Hangman should always make a number four. It just does, because that's the meaning of the card. It talks about one's perspective of one's security. If you look at Hangman cards, they make a number four with their legs. Fours are actually hidden in a lot of tarot cards, because without your fours, you're losing yourself. It's kind of like the North Node. It's where you find your strength, your security, what you call home within yourself. And the Four of Pentacles reverses, I feel like somebody's changing out their Four of Wands, releasing something they held on to for a long time. Maybe you felt alone in a given situation. Maybe a job has released you. But if it has, it's only putting you on the path to something much, much better. I do feel like a release. And some of you, it's a contemplation with the Knight of Swords reverse, overthinking about, should I leave this, whatever I'm in now, for this new? Because whatever this new thing is, it makes you feel really, really good. Two of Wands. Yeah, I feel like you're wrestling with a decision. Three of Swords reverse and the Page of Swords. Did you meet somebody online, maybe? The Devil, strong-ass connection here. Queen of Wands, passion. Nine of Swords reverse. Yeah, I feel like you're wrestling with a big decision. King of Cups, reason for the reading. King of Cups, reason for the reading for the Aquarians. What is the King of Cups, reason for the reading? I feel like this is momentous, a huge decision. What is this King of Cups, Scorpio energy? And again, maybe it's coming in Scorpio season if this hasn't happened yet. What's the King of Cups, reason for the reading? It's the Three of Pentacles. Three of Pentacles is about building. It's weird because I conceived a work scenario too. If I'm work-wise, it's easy. Go for it. Whatever you're feeling drawn to, go for it. We're in the energy where dreams are coming true. Three of Pentacles is you have to put your energy into it, though. You have to believe it. You have to make yourself open to it. That means you have to let people know you want it. Some people work and they are expecting somebody to just know that they want a certain position. And people aren't mind readers. You have to speak up and put yourself out there. And yeah, that's what you have to really pursue that. And I feel like you're really going to get it, and it would change a lot in your life, because I just remember that King of Pentacles. But going back to the relationship thing, is I feel like you were talking to, it feels like there's something new building with somebody new. Judgment is waking up to the love in your life, waking up to how much love you have been missing out on, or how much you've been settling with not having it at all. Two of Wands reverse. I feel like this is a permanent decision being made. Three of Swords and the Strength reverse. I just don't. And the Fool reverse. Okay, let's see what's going on. What's the Queen of Cups reverse in the past? What's the Queen of Cups reverse in the past for the Aquarians? Queen of Cups reverse in the past. Cancerian energy. That's a lot. But maybe it wanted to show me High Priestess and Hierophant. Ooh, and that's a true pair. High Priestess and the Hierophant, by the way. Kind of weird because it's brother, sister, I think more. But Hangman, the Five of Wands, Five of Pentacles. I just feel like an Aquarian's wrestling with a big decision. Should I stay or should I go? Do I go towards what my heart wants, or do I stay where people rely on me? I felt like that Three of Swords at the bottom there was you don't want to hurt anybody. What is the Queen of Cups reverse in the past? Queen of Cups reversed in the past. You have to do, it's a hard thing. Because you know what? Life and tarot are two different things. Tarot makes things sound easy. In life, people get hurt. People get disappointed. But I have to read it as the tarot reading, okay? I feel like you have to start filling up your own cup. I feel like somebody's coming in and they want your healing waters where you've been in something and they forgot that you even have this within you. I feel like somebody has almost forgotten you. Queen of Cups reverse and a Queen of Cups reverse is feeling, I just don't think your emotional needs have been being met in the recent past. I really don't. Five of Swords reverse and a Nine of Swords reverse. Some of you are wrestling with leaving something behind here, a long-term commitment. What's the judgment on your mind? What's the judgment on Aquarian's mind? What's the judgment on Aquarian's mind? What's the judgment on Aquarian's mind? It's waking up. You know, for some of you, this is about making yourself vulnerable again. Vulnerable. I can't even speak. Vulnerable again to new love. And I can just hear some people saying, that's not my reading because I don't have anyone. That's part of it too. That's the Queen of Cups reverse saying, it's not my reading because I don't have anyone. Therefore, you still have that Two of Swords. You have that blindfold on because you've kind of lost the ability to hope that it can come in. The judgment is saying I feel like it's almost a defense mechanism to protect your heart from being hurt. And that's part of what's changing and healing too with this judgment on your mind. What is this judgment? Because you realize the one thing that may scare you is what you want the most, which is love, which is acceptance, which being loved fully. Having passion back in one's life. What's the judgment on your mind? And this King of Swords reverse. Some of you have a hard time letting new in. King of Swords reverse, that's your energy, that's your card. Exactly. I mean, I'm talking to the cards. See how this King of Swords, even if he's upright, he's learned so many lessons being a king that he's never gonna, he doesn't want to put himself in a position to hurt somebody, ever, to get hurt by somebody again. So he's like, I'll help you, but you get to hold the pointy end of the sword. I'm holding where I'm not going to get hurt. And then I also feel something with giving the point of the sword. It's like a very tricky situation coming in. Because some of you may be married. I feel like it would be you being the one committed. You could be dealing with somebody committed, but it's a tricky situation. But a King of Swords reverse is not able to see something or trying to push something energetically away that you can't push away. Ten of Pentacles, Eight of Cups, the Tower. Something sudden coming in. Somebody who wants to invest in you. And Eight of Pentacles is long-term. Strong foundation. And again, with the work, I mean, I'm getting such a strong work read too. It's Queen King of Swords reverses is opening your horizon to something new, something you forgot you wanted. Because the King of Swords reverse can be very, very protective of one's energy and heart. Very protective. Why the King of Swords reverse on your mind? It's not wanting to change, even though you know you want the change. What is that? And the Page of Swords reverse. You don't want to be disappointed again. If this is a new love or whatever this new thing is, you just don't want to be disappointed in it again, but you actually crave it. With the Knight of Cups being reversed here, King of Cups at the reason for the reading, and the Three of Pentacles, you want it. And it scares you that you want it. Because you're so strong, you're going to go after it. You just don't want to be back here again. What is this Hangman and the Knight of Cups reversed in the near future for the Aquarians? Pisces and Pisces. Hangman upright and the Knight of Cups reverse. It's funny because if you look at the Hangman, it says it's perspective, limbo, sacrifice, letting go, and surrender. Enlightenment delays reflection and insight. I feel like that's where it is do you let go or do you surrender to this new love and let go of something? Or do you stay tied to something familiar that may not necessarily have been happy, but it has been what has been known and safe? What is the perspective in the Knight of Cups reverse? What is that? And the Nine of Pentacles and the Queen of Pentacles again and the Emperor again. I feel like this is you, actually, Aquarius. Emperor, Queen of Pentacles, and the Nine of Pentacles. We have Capricorn, Virgo, and Aries going on here. I feel like you're leveling up. I think it's... If, again, let's go to the work. This is about putting yourself out there, even if you could be told no, but doing it anyway. Because there's something that would make you very happy, which could be around money, but I feel like it's more about being accepted and being appreciated for what you do and being honored by it or being rewarded by it monetarily. I think you probably do it anyway and you're not getting paid for it. This is about being recognized for what you do, and but you have to, I feel like some of you are just waiting to be seen and waiting to be offered. And I want to say, I don't even know if this is in work, they even know what you want. And I think it's the King of Cups and the Three of Pentacles is about being vulnerable to what you want and ready to build on that, build on it. You need more. You just need more. This is somebody who needs more, and they've been trying to convince themselves that they're okay. You're not okay. I mean, with the Knight of Cups reverse with against the King of Cups, this is telling me that when this comes in, you're going to really, really want it. And some of you, this is a relationship already in. If this is a relationship, and you know you really want it, but you're trying to figure out, do I leave something behind for it? Or do I make myself vulnerable and open to having this? Judgment says there's a new way of living, there's a new way of being, because the old you, reserving your cup, you can't hold your cup back and expect reciprocity. Because I feel like you could have put yourself out there and got rejected and hurt. You don't want to do that to somebody else. And whatever this is coming in, this is somebody who wants to really be here in the long term, especially if it's Nine of Pentacles. And then we had the Judgment, the Eight of Pentacles, the Hangman. I feel like you got somebody who really wants to be here, who really wants to be with you. But there might be a fear that it's kind of like this Three of Pentacles. If you look at it this way, you're willing to maybe throw in three, but they got to throw in seven. I do feel like you should hold yourself back until people prove who they are and all, but you just don't want to do to somebody what was done to you, which is being emotionally unavailable. King of Swords reverses Aquarius. It's a bit emotionally unavailable because he's been hurt. And he's just like, Page of Swords reverse. I don't want this immature energy. So I feel it's good. I feel it's new, but I feel like it's scary for you to actually allow yourself to change. It's funny because Judgment has changed, but a King of Swords reverse doesn't change. It's very, very, very conflicting energies. And it would take a Judgment card to come in to change this person's mind. I feel like maybe what the mindset is the lack of belief that somebody actually can treat you well and treat you right after having people who didn't, related to, married to, friendship, whatever it is. And you got somebody who says, hey, Aquarius, where you been? I've been looking for you. And you're just like, oh God, it's another Page of Swords reverse. Is this someone I'm gonna have to raise? Is this someone I'm gonna have to get over? And this person's like, what are you talking about? You know, it's opening your horizons to this. Yeah, King of Wands reverse, the Page of Wands reverse. I feel like this, when this comes in, this is gonna be you, because you dealt with disappointment. I think you do well with almost dealing with disappointment, because you know how to deal with it. You know how to cut it out. But I don't know if you know how to handle something really good. That is scary shit right there. So yeah, Page of Cups, King of Cups, you got something new. It makes you feel really good, but I actually think the Nine of Cups reverse is you. I think you have somebody trying to give you their cup and you don't see somebody else here. It's reversed. It's like you're might be pulling yourself back from it and getting a perspective to see, is this person a Page of Swords reverse, or are they really the king they say they are? It's what I'm getting, Aquarius. Good luck with this. Yeah, it just feels very conflicted and in one's head about it, but it's good. It feels good, you know? All right, guys, have a fantastic rest of your week. If you want to join me tomorrow morning, 8 a.m. Central Standard Time, please do. If not, have a great weekend. Have a great weekend anyway, you know? All right, Aquarius, you guys have a great rest of your week. Take care.